Same story.
His Majesty leapt up, raging against them. He grabbed his weapons and set off at a gallop, completely alone. His Majesty was an unstoppable fighting force. Everything near him was ablaze with fire. All the foreign lands were blasted by his scorching breath.
He claims that, single-handedly, after his troops had deserted him, he went into the field of battle, slashing, swaying his sword back and forth, decimating the enemies of Egypt.
He charged straight into the Hittite troops. The infantry and chariotry fell on their faces. His Majesty struck them down and killed them where they stood.
The claims of Ramses II that his army totally abandoned him, that he was left alone on the field of battle and single-handedly defeated the Hittites, of course, is an utter load of rubbish.
Despite his boasting, Ramesses knew that his army could not defeat the Hittites. He had to cut a deal. Secretly, Ramesses began to negotiate with the Hittites. After lengthy debate, Ramesses signed a treaty with the Hittite king. Ramesses the spin doctor was now Ramesses the statesman. A copy of the treaty is still preserved in the most holy of temples at Karnak, chiseled onto a wall.
I, the great Hittite ruler, am at peace with Ramesses, the great king of Egypt, and enjoy his brotherhood. All the people of Egypt and all the Hittite people will be at peace like us forever.
Covering issues of royal succession, extradition, and amnesty for refugees, the treaty remains a model that is still followed today.
Here you have the two superpowers of the day sitting down around a table and saying, what we need to do is to build up a lasting peace, to build up an alliance which will mutually benefit both our sides.
To seal the treaty, Ramesses married one of the Hittite king's daughters.
The Hittite princess was part of the terms of the peace treaty. She was, if you like, the cement in the treaty. She's brought into the presence of Ramesses, and therefore, by extension, into the Egyptian Empire.
The Hittite princess was brought to Egypt's new capital, located in the Nile Delta in northern Egypt. It was called Per Ramesses, meaning the House of Ramesses. Far from the old aristocracy center of power in Thebes, Per Ramesses was carefully situated in the north to keep an eye on the Hittites. It was to be a new capital for a new regime.
This was the Brasilia of ancient Egypt. This was the new capital. This was something that was going to be the beginning of a new regeneration of the country. He's saying, I am a new man, this is a new Egypt, and the traditional aristocracy had just better come to terms with this.
On the banks of the Nile, Ramesses adorned his capital with all the treasures the empire had to offer. Eyewitnesses tell of a lushness and opulence unsurpassed in Egypt.
I have reached.